Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger. In this video, we are going to look at the second problem in our quiz, which concerned a pentagon and building squares symmetrically from each of the sides of the pentagon so that the squares meet just at the corners. So that determines the ratio of the side of the square to the side of the pentagon, and we're interested in that ratio. So let's say the side of the pentagon is D, a length, the side of the square is E, another length. We might ask, what is D over E? And a second question was, how do we compare the radius of the big circle going through the vertices of the pentagon with this smaller circle inscribed in the squares? Okay, so analysis of a pentagon rests crucially in rational trigonometry with two special spreads called the golden spreads. They're called alpha and beta, and here they are right here. And this was discussed in WildTrig 25, so please have a look at that. But I remind you of the basic facts, that beta is the spread between this and this line here. So it's the spread subtended at the center by an edge of the pentagon. And if we split one of those into two by a bisector, then each of these spreads is alpha. So two alphas together make a beta, but also beta and beta together make an alpha. So this is our second spread polynomial, the logistic map, which tells us what happens to a spread if we double the sector. And so we now see that S2 of alpha equals beta, and S2 of beta equals alpha. That's sort of a defining property of the two golden spreads. And alpha corresponds to 36 degrees or 144 degrees, and beta to 72 degrees or the complement 108 degrees. So armed with this, let's have a look at this configuration, try to figure out what is D over E. So here we've blown up one of the vertices of the pentagon a little bit. So there's A, there's the center of the pentagon, and here are two of our squares. The side of the pentagon is length D, the side of the square is E, and if we take D and we subtract E, and then we divide by 2, then we get this length right here. So have a look at this triangle right here, which is a right triangle. One of its sides is length E. The other side has length D minus E over 2. And that spread right there is 1 minus alpha. I remind you, that's because if we drop a perpendicular to here, then this spread was alpha. So this is just 1 minus alpha. All right, so in this triangle here, 1 minus alpha is a spread. So it's the quadrants of the opposite side divided by the quadrants of the hypotenuse. E squared divided by, well, this hypotenuse, its quadrants by Pythagoras, will be E squared plus D minus E over 2 all squared, right there. So that's just really the definition of a spread. We're interested in this ratio D over E, so let's set that equal to X. That's convenient because if we divide top and bottom here by E squared, then that becomes 1, that becomes 1, and what's inside here, well, there's a D over E minus 1. So it'll be like an X minus 1. So if we multiply by 4 also, then we'll get 1 minus alpha, which is 3 plus root 5 over 8, equals 4 divided by 4 plus this X minus 1 all squared. And if we bring that to the other side and then divide by that, we get X minus 1 squared equals 32 over 3 plus root 5 minus 4. And then you can rationalize this kind of expression. If you take something like this and you want to simplify it, you multiply the top and the bottom by 3 minus root 5. I remind you, that's how you simplify something like that. And you do that and you get 20 minus 8 root 5. So X, or our ratio D over E, is the square root of that, plus 1. And there it is there, 2 square root of 5 minus 2 root 5, plus 1. And that's approximately the decimal expansion for it. Now, with ordinary classical trigonometry, chances are you'd end up with some portion of that answer. But I'm trying to get you to think that having a portion of this answer is not really very acceptable. It's only an approximation, while this is the real goods. This is the correct answer. This is an approximate, ultimately incorrect answer, I'm afraid. Okay, that's great. So now let's have a look at the ratios of these radii of circles. So let's go back to the geometry of our pentagon. Here it is again. And let's do everything with rational trigonometry now. So let's suppose that the quadrants of the side is Q. So that would be what we were calling D squared before. And let's say that the quadrants of this circle is capital R. And this perpendicular quadrants here, let's call that H. And this spread here, that's our golden spread alpha. Okay, so in this triangle here, the triangle OMA, we know the three quadrants, R, H, and this one here will be Q divided by 4, because it's half of this side with quadrants Q. Okay, so that makes things easy to evaluate. The alpha in this triangle here will be opposite over hypotenuse, so Q over 4 divided by R. And also, if we consider this spread here, which will be 1 minus alpha, then its definition is 1 minus alpha is H over R, right there. Okay, so these are pretty simple to solve. We can solve for R from the first one. So we get Q over 4 and 1 over alpha right there. When we rationalize that, we get 5 plus root 5 over 10 times Q. So that's R in terms of Q. The radius or the quadrants of the circle in terms of the side of the pentagon. And then H from here will just be 1 minus alpha times this R. So we have to take this number and we multiply it by 1 minus alpha, which was that 3 plus root 5 over 8. And you work that out and you get 5 plus 2 root 5 over 20 times Q. So that tells us how to get the circumscribed quadrants or the inscribed quadrants of a pentagon whose side quadrants is Q. All right, so now let's go back to our original problem with a side length of D for the pentagon, a side length of E for the square. And let's let the quadrants of the two circles be RB and RL for big and little. So this is quadrants RB, and this quadrant from here to here will be R little. Okay, what is RB? Well, according to this, it's 5 plus root 5 over 10 times the quadrants of the side of the pentagon, which is D squared. And what is RL? Well, according to this, it's 5 plus 2 root 5 over 20 times the quadrants of the side of the square, which is E squared. And then if we take the ratio of these two things, we get this thing here divided by this thing here, and there'll be a 2 there, times D over E all squared. D over E is what we were calling X. And very pleasantly, this little quotient here turns out to be a square. It turns out to be, in fact, just root 5 minus 1 all squared. If we take the square root of that, then the ratio of the lengths of the radii, little rb over little rl, is root 5 minus 1 times the value x that we found on the previous page. And that turns out to be approximately 3.03. So we've solved our second problem in the quiz. The third problem has to do with a right triangle, one of whose spreads is trisected. We're going to do that next time. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.